When we want to buy our next dream home, we consider factors like location, distance to schools, amenities and facilities. And here is another big question, whether to buy a brand new home or a resale property. Hi, I'm Raymond Koo from Orange Tea and Thai. Welcome to Property Made Easy online series episode 3. In today's episode, I will be unpacking the topic of new homes versus resale property and how it will affect your property investment decision. Resale properties offer larger floor plate, immediate occupation, and immediate returns if you are an investor. New homes provide swanky facilities aimed to please with lifestyle services that take care of your well-being. Developers' pricing strategy often increases the value when it completes construction. The question is new homes worth the wait? Consideration number one, is lower PSF a safer bet? Though new homes command a higher PSF, it is proven to appreciate over the course of construction due to developers' pricing strategy. Let's look at a few examples. If you have bought Tanglin View in 2015, it would have appreciated only 12%. Comparing with Principal Gardens, the appreciation is 17.5%. If you have bought Trivista in January 2015, it would only appreciate 16.3% over 5 years. Comparing with Gem Residences in the same period of time, the appreciation is 33.9%. If you had bought Seletar Springs in 2015, the project would have appreciated 9.3%. Comparing with High Park Residences, the appreciation is 21.7%. So, buying a lower PSF doesn't equate to a higher potential. New homes appreciate in the cost of construction and stakeholders entering at the same price. They will all want to sell at a profit. Comparing your resale properties, you may have bought at a higher price than your neighbors and they can sell at your buying price and still make a profit. Consideration number two, is location critical for rentability? According to 1991 Singapore Concept Plan, URA embarked on diffusing commercial activities to a series of regional centers. This brought a change in residential rental demand. Furthermore, with the operation of new MRT lines, it brought transportation convenience to a new level. Tenants do not mind to live further away from the CBD in order to save on monthly rental. Consideration number three, hoping to hit the en bloc jackpot. The fact is, not all properties have en bloc potential. Almost 30 sites failed en bloc in 2018. En bloc potential is determined by whether the value of surrounding land and properties have appreciated significantly, and if the condo's land potential is not yet fully utilized. And lastly, the market outlook is positive. If you are hoping to hit the en bloc jackpot, it may not be as easy as you think. So, the question is, why do people still prefer resale properties given that new homes provide a swanky new feel and better investment potential? The widening price gap due to higher land costs and increasing construction costs makes resale properties attractive. 3 years of waiting time for a home to be built may be too long for some house hunters. The immediate need for a roof over their heads is compelling. Investors who can afford to wait will make a profit when the construction is completed. In conclusion, brand new homes offers you a good investment proposition and resale property gives you an immediate solution for your housing needs. Choosing the right property all depends on your needs and wants. I hope that you have benefited from today's sharing. Thank you for watching. Do follow us on all our social media channels and remember to like and subscribe. Once again, I'm Raymond Khoo. See you in our next episode.